This video you are going to see what is signal flow graph and how to reduce the signal flow graph problem. The signal flow graph is used to represent the control system graphically and it was developed by S.J. Mason. This is the definition of signal flow graph. Yes, the signal flow graph is a graphical representation of the relationship between variables of a set of linear algebraic equation. A signal flow graph consists of network in which nodes are connected by direct branches. The flow of signal from one point of a system to another and gives a relationship among the signals. Simply, the signal flow graph is the graphical representation of the control system. These are the fundamentals of signal flow graph. Consider a simple equation. This is the algebraic equation y is equal to a into x. This can be represented in the form of signal flow graph. Here, x and y are the variables. Y is the output, x is the input variable. Then a is one constant or gain. Here in signal flow graph, the variables are represented as a node. Here input variable x, the output variable y, then the gain a. Then the output y is equal to input signal x into a. Every variable in a signal flow graph is designed by a node. Here x and y are the variable that are designed by a node. This is node, this is also another one node. Then every transmission function in a signal flow graph is designed by a branch. Here the node is connected by using a straight line. Then here mark A, this is branch. This is a branch. Then branch is always a unidirectional. Here arrow mark is there, only one direction, one way. The arrow in the branch denotes the direction of the signal flow graph. Then some terminologies of the signal flow graph. Here in this is a one example signal flow graph. Here in the signal flow graph, here x1 is the input node, or another name of input node is source. The input node only contains outgoing branches. There is no incoming branches. The branch is come out from the node. That is called input node, or another name of input node is source. Then output node. Here in this signal flow graph, X4 is the output node, or another name of output node is sink. It contains only the incoming branches. Here this is one incoming branch. This is another one incoming branch. Here there is no outgoing branch. Then path. Path or the forward path. The forward path means it connects the input node to output node. Here x1 to x2, then x2 to x3, then x3 to x4. This is one path. Then another one path, x1 to x2, then x2 to directly bypass to x4. No node is passed more than once. This example consists of two paths, two forward paths. Feedback loop or feedback path. That is the closed path. Here x2 to x3, then x3 to x2 again. This is one closed loop. This is called a feedback loop. Here this one is not a feedback loop because the arrow mark is opposite direction. This direction, here the arrow mark is in the opposite direction. Then self loop. This is called a self loop. Self loop also a feedback loop, consists of a single branch. It only contains a single branch of gain A33. Here this is the self loop. Then gain. Gain of the branch is the transmission function of the branch. The transmission function, here this is the gain A21, A22, A4, A32, A43, A42, A23, these are the gain. Then path gain, that is the forward path gain. Here this example consists of two forward paths, X1 to X2, then X3, then X4. That is one forward path. The gain of this, the gain is A21, A32, then A43. The multiplication of this, the gain products of the branches are called the path gain, the loop gain. Here this is the loop. Here the loop consists of two gains. The product of this gain is called loop gain, A32 and A23. This is the loop gain of this loop, X2 to X3, then X3 to again X2. This loop, the loop gain is A32 and A23. The non-touching loop, there is no common node. Here, this is one loop, this is one self loop. This both loop has a common node X3. So these two are a touching loops. Non-touching loop means there is no common node. Then block diagram to signal flow graph. How to convert one block diagram into signal flow graph? Here it consists of a simple block diagram. Here in this block diagram consists of RF is the input, then C of S is the output, then two summing points, then this is another one input N of S, then these are the blocks G1 of S, G2 of S and Kaich of S. Corresponding gains are marked in the blocks. Now, how to convert this block diagram into signal flow graph? First step, input node, output node, summing points and takeoff points are assigned as a node. So, then draw a nodes first. R of S is the input, C of S is the output. Then here this is one summing point. Then here another one summing point here. First mark these nodes. Here there is here on takeoff point. Mark this takeoff point also. Then connect the nodes. Connects the nodes by using a straight line with orientation direction. Then beside the line mark the gain value. Here there is no gain means that value is equal to 1. The unity gain. Here mark 1. Here R of S to the summing point. There is no gain. Simply straight line. Here put the gain value is equal to 1. Then here this node E of S. Then E of S to another summing point. E of S to the another summing point. The gain value is G of S1. This is the orientation direction. Then here this node is N of S input node, another one input node. Then input node to here this summing point node. Here the gain value is 1 because here no gain. Then this summing point to the takeoff point, the gain is G2 of S. Here mark G2 of S. Then this takeoff point node to the output, the gain value is 1. This is the orientation. Here C of S. Then this is feedback loop. Feedback loop is taken from the takeoff point node to the first summing point. Here the gain value is H of S. This is the procedure to draw a signal flow graph from the block diagram. Signal flow graph of a system can be reduced either by using rule of the signal flow graph, algebra or using Mason's gain formula. The first method, that is the rule of the signal flow graph, write a equation at every network and rearrange the equation to get the ratio of output and input, that is the transfer function. That will be time consuming and tedious. The second method, the Mason's gain formula has developed, and this is a simple procedure to determine the transfer function of the system. Now let's see the Mason's gain formula. The Mason's formula used to determine the transfer function from the signal flow graph of the system. Let R of S is the input of the system, then C of S is the output of the system. So that the transfer function T of S is equal to C of S divided by R of S. Laplace transform of output divided by Laplace transform of input. The Mason's gain formula states that the overall gain of the system, the overall gain means that is the transfer function of the system, is equal to 1 by delta summation k pk and delta k. Here, T is the transfer function of the system. Pk is the forward path gain of the kth forward path. Already we saw about the forward path. Forward path means the number of possible way from the input node to output node. what are the possible way to the output node from the input node. That is called a forward path. Then K is the number of forward path. Total number of forward path. How many number of possible forward paths are present in the signal flow graph. Then delta. Delta formula is 1 minus sum of individual loop gains. Individual loop, already we saw about the loop. Loop means this is a closed path. The closed path. Here the multiplication of the gain product is called the gain, loop gain. Here the sum of the individual loop gain. Suppose that in a problem, three loops are present means the add the three loop gains. Then plus sum of the gain product of all possible combinations of two non-touching loop gains. Suppose two loops are non-touching, that is there is no common node for this two loop, that is a non-touching loop. And that combination form that combinations, then find the product of this loop gains. Then again minus sum of the gain product of all possible combinations of three non-touching loop. So then again plus, here the sign is in alternate, first sign plus one, then minus, then plus, minus, then plus, etc. Then delta k, delta part of the graph which is not touching the kth forward path. This formula is important. We know this formula. We can easily simplify the signal flow graph and find out the transfer function. Now let's see one example problem. Find the overall transfer function of the system whose signal flow graph is shown in figure. Here the signal flow graph consists of R of S is the input node. Here this is C of S. C of S is the output node. Then first step, find out the forward path. Forward path gains. Forward path means what are the possible way go from input side to output node. The input node to output node. First identify the ways. Here this node to 2. Then 2 to 3, then 3 to 4, 4 to 5, then 5 to 6, 6 to 7 and 7 to 8. Here this is one direct path, input node to output node. Then check the another possible way. Here 1 to 2, then 2 to 5 bypassing, 2 to 5, then 5 to 6. 6 to 7, then 7 to 8. This is another way, another route for going from input to output node. This way. Also check for another possible ways. 1 to 2, then 2 to 3, then 3 to 4 is not possible because this is one way. The arrow mark is opposite direction. Also the 3 to 5. 3 to 5, this is also not possible. This is also one way opposite direction. This one way is possible. It already goes through this way. Then here 6 to 7, this way is not possible because this is also one way direction. So this problem has two forward path. The forward path gains are indicated as the letter K. Total number of forward path is K. K is equal to 2. Then draw the forward path separately. No problem to take the first, here the second one is first or the first one is second. Draw this forward paths. Then give the name for the forward paths. First forward path is here taken as the letter P1. Then second forward path gain is taken as the letter P2. Then find the gain of this forward path. Gain is just to multiply the transmission gains. Just to multiply the gains, here the gain values are 1, G1, G2, G3, G4, G5 and 1. Our P1 is equal to multiply this gain, G1, G2, G3, G4 and G5. That is the gain of the first forward path. Then second forward path gain. Second forward path gain is indicated as the letter P2. Here they multiply the gains. Our the gain product is G4, G5 and G6. P2 is equal to G4, G5 and G6. This is the first step. Then second step, identify the individual loops. Identifying the loops, here this is one loop. 3 to 4, then 4 to again 3. This is one loop. Then here this is another one loop. 3 to 4, then 4 to 5, then 5 to again 3. This is one closed path. This is one loop, second loop. Then here another one loop. 6 to 7, then 7 to again 6. This is another one loop. Now in the second step, draw the loops separately. I am going to draw this loop separately. Here I draw the loop, this loop, then second this loop, then third one is this loop. Here also draw like this, the first loop can draw second or third, or second loop is draw first, that is no problem. Identify all the loops and draw the loops in any one order, then write the order, loop 1, loop 2 and loop 3. Then give this name, the loop gain of individual loop 1, first loop 1. Here P1, P2 and P3. Here the first number 1, 2, 3. This indicates the serial number of the loop. Then second 1, 1, 1. This once indicates the individual. So the first individual loop P1, 1 is equal to, the first individual loop gain is P11 is equal to, just multiply these gains, minus G2 into H1. Then second individual loop gain is equal to minus G2 G3 H2. Minus G2 G3 H2. Then third individual loop gain is equal to minus G5 into H3. These are the gains of the individual loops. Then third step, identify the two non-touching loops. Non-touching loop means there is no a common node. Here nodes are marked in this step. Here 3 and 4 are the node. Here in the second loop, 3, 4, 5 are the nodes. Here compare these two loops. Here 3 and 4 is there. Here also 3 and 4 is there. So this two loops has a common node. So this is a touching loop. These two loops are a touching loop. Then the first loop is compared with the third loop. Here 3, 4 is the node. Here 6, 7 is the node. So here there is no common node. So these two loops are non-touching loop. Here this is the loop. This is the loop. These two loops are separate area. These two loops are present in the separate area. These two loops are not touches directly. This is non-touching loops. Then the second loop is compared with a third loop. Second loop is compared with third loop. Here 3, 4, 5. Here 6, 7. Here also there is no common node. 3, 4, 5. Here 6, 7. This number is not repeated here. So this two nodes are non-touching loops. That is this loop and this loop. These loops are actually present separately. That is non-touching loops. Then draw this combination. First draw this combination. Then draw this combination. That is the third step. The first combination. These two loops. This loop and this loop. These two loops are non-touching. Draw here. Then second combination, this loop and this loop. These two loops are non-touching, draw here. Then find the gain product of the first combination of the two non-touching gain product. Here also P1, P2. The first number indicate the serial number. 1, 2. First non-touching loop, second non-touching loop. Then 2 indicate the two non-touching. 2 indicates, the second number indicates 2 non-touching. Here, first gain product of the first combination of 2 non-touching loop gain. 2 non-touching loop is equal to multiply all the gain values. Here minus into minus plus, then G2, G5, H1, H3. Multiply G2, G5, H1, H3. Then, second combination of two non-touching loop gain is equal to two non-touching loop gain product is equal to this one minus G2, G3, H2 into minus G5, H3. Then multiplied these two, G2, G3, G5, G2 into H3. Then check the three possible combination is present in this problem or not. Three non-touching loop is not present. Go to or otherwise calculate delta and delta k. The delta formula, delta means 1 minus sum of individual loop gain plus sum of two non-touching loop gains minus sum of three non-touching loop gains. Here in this problem, there is no three and four non-touching loop gains of the formula up to this. Then write 1 minus P11, P21, P31 values are already calculated. That values are just to substitute here. Then P12 and P21. That value is also substitute here. Then multiply this sign inside. We get 1 plus G2H1 plus G2 G3H2 plus G5 G3 plus G2 G5 H1 into H3 plus G2 G3 G5 H2 H3. Then calculate delta 1. Here this problem consists of two forward paths. So K is equal to 2. First of all calculate delta 1. Then calculate delta 2. Then delta 1 means 1 minus the loop not touches the first forward path. Just look at the problem. Here this loop touches the first forward path because this loop is 3 and 4. 3 and 4 is present in this forward path. Then second loop 3, 4, 5. Again this loop. Again 3. This 3 and 4. 3, 4, 5 touches the first forward path. Then 6, 7, 2, 6. This is also touches the first forward path. So all loops are touches the first forward path. So the value is equal to 1 minus 0. So this value delta 1 is equal to 1. Then the formula is 1 minus the loop which is not touches the second forward path plus the combination of two loops which are not touches the second forward path minus etc. Okay. Here now check the loops and non-touching loops. The loops which are touches the second forward path or not. These are the individual loops. The individual loop is compared with the second forward path. The second forward path is this one. This is the second forward path. Here, the second forward path nodes are 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here in the second forward path, there is no 3 and 4. So this loop is not touches the second forward path. Clean loop, this loop. This loop only not touches the second forward path. So the formula becomes 1 minus the loop which is not touches the second forward path. That loop is P11 loop only. Here I draw the P11 loop here. Then multiply this gain product minus G2 into H1. Here already 1 minus is there in the problem. So minus into minus plus 1 plus G2 into H1. Then after that finally find out all the values are now calculated. Then substitute the values in the transfer function. That is the last step. Transfer function T is equal to, I write the Mason's gain formula. T is equal to 1 by delta summation K PK into delta K. Here K is equal to 2. Number of forward path is equal to 2. So expand the summing point. P1 delta 1 plus P2 into delta 2. P1 is the first forward path gain. P2 is the second forward path gain. Then delta 1 delta. This is delta 1 is equal to 1. Then delta 2 is equal to 1 plus G2 into H1. Then P1 first forward path gain is G1, G2, G3, G4, G5 into delta 1 value 1. Then P2 is the second forward path gain. G4, G5, G6. Second forward path gain. G4, G4, G5, G6 into delta 2. Delta 2 is 1 plus G2 into H1. 4 divided by delta. This is the delta value. They just substitute the delta value here. This is the transfer function of the system. That is enough. That is the transfer function of the system. The important point to be considered to solve the problem is to identify all forward paths and individual loops. If you identify all forward path and individual loop, means easily simplify the problem. Suppose missing any loop and or the forward path, is the problem solution is go wrong. So carefully identify all individual loops and the forward paths. Don't miss any forward paths and individual loops. Then only the problem solution is come correctly. Follow the same step for all signal flow graph problems. Thank you.